Hello everybody, this is your Amakuti Natasha Doshi and I'm here to talk about Jai Simha. Before I start everything, let me just tell you Sankranti Subhakankshalu and a little about me now. I'm basically from Bombay. I am born and brought up in Mumbai. My mother is a Malayali and my father is a Gujarati. So essentially, I'm a mix of two very different states and of course I live in Mumbai. That's a little about me. And educationally, I am a dentist, so I'm actually Dr. Natasha Doshi, and I'm here talking about my Telugu debut, Jai Simha, with Bala sir, and it's my privilege to be here today. How I got NBK 102, so actually more than me coming to the movie came to me. Kalyan sir and Ravi sir were looking for an actress to do my role. And I think they had seen over 100 girls to do my role and they weren't happy with anything. Everyone that they kept meeting, they were rejecting because they hadn't found the right person for it. And then when they actually came across my photos via some people, and when they saw it, they called me down. I went, I heard the story. I had a beautiful story. I fell in love with the story right then. And I had nothing to think about because it was directed by Ravi sir. It was Kalyan sir's banner. And most importantly, I was getting to do my Telugu debut opposite Bala sir. So it was the best thing that's ever happened to me in 2017.
What is your character?
My character's name is Dania. And you have to forgive me for this. We aren't actually allowed to talk a lot about our character because our story is such where if we talk a little too much about our character, it kind of gives out the story. It's a puzzle and everything is very interlinked. But I can tell you a little bit about my character. My character, Dania, she is actually living abroad. She is an NRI. And Murli sir is playing my father, Murli Mohan. He's my Nana in the movie. And Murli sir is a very conservative and orthodox person. He is he's the head of the temple in Kumbakonam. And he didn't have a daughter for many, many years. And finally, he had a daughter who is Dania. So they treat her like a princess. They give her whatever she wants. She's a spoiled girl. I'm living abroad and when I come back to my village, the incidents that take place and what happens then is what goes around my character in the story. Bala sir is one of the most energetic and enthusiastic persons I've ever come across. He is filled with energy, filled with happiness and joy. And to be around him, you actually kind of imbibe that energy and it makes you want to do more and you want to like push yourself to have the same energy level. And in general, even I'm quite an energetic person. But Bala sir, of course, he is probably one of the most inspiring people you'll meet. And he inspires me to be better, you know.
Any memorable moment in shooting time?
I wouldn't be able to pick one because every single day has been memorable shooting for this film. And in fact, on the last day of the shoot, I actually almost had tears in my eyes because we had grown as a family. So there was such a close bond and everyone that I worked with, whether it's my crew, whether it's the technicians, whether it was our DOP, our assistant directors, everyone really went out of their way to make me feel at home and help me feel warm. So I never had any hesitation that, okay, I'm new to this industry and I'm new to this city. So I never had any of those problems and they really helped me feel happy, and that's why I'm always happy and thrilled to come to Hyderabad and thrilled to come and work in Telugu. K.S. Ravi Kumar. He is one of the greatest and finest directors in the country. So to actually get this opportunity where he thought I was worthy enough to do a role in his movie, it meant a lot to me. He didn't have any second thoughts when he saw me. The minute he saw me, he knew that this is the girl I want in this movie for this character, and that itself gave me so much confidence when one of the greatest directors who's directed Rajinikanth sir, Kamal Haasan sir, thinks I am worthy enough to be a part of his project. And Ravi sir is one of the most intelligent persons I've ever come across. He is a genius. His method of directing is very different because he would actually enact every single scene for every single character in the movie, whether it was Bala sir, whether it was Nayantara, whether it was Prakash Raj, whether it was me. He would enact the scene for every single person because that's his way of directing, you know. He will show us what he wants. He has a specific vision in his head. And once he shows it to us, he expects us to do the same thing, but with our body language. So he's very clear about what he wants and he's very helpful. I look at him like my father, and he is truly inspiring. He is one of the most humble and down-to-earth directors I've come across, who despite being at the position where he is, and despite being at the status and reputation of him, he is still very down-to-earth, and I hope to be that way. Yeah, Kalyan sir. So, you know, I think I've been really lucky that I've been blessed to work with people who are superly dedicated and sincere to this project. You know, of course, when you go to any movie set, you always come across hardworking people, because making a movie is not an easy job. You know, of course, it requires a lot of hard work, a lot of effort. But this movie, the one thing that really touched me was this, that everyone, despite being hardworking, was passionate about what they do. You know, whether it was our technicians, whether it was our lightmen, whether it was the makeup crew, everyone was passionate about giving their best, and that's why I think that makes a difference. And that also, I would like to say the same thing about Kalyan sir. He's not, of course, as a producer, he's paying people to come to work for him, but that never meant he would ever sit on the set. If he was ever there on location, he would be the most hands-on person, going from here to there, getting things done, because he knows that he doesn't need to do it, but he would still do it, because that's his dedication and his passion for filmmaking. And you know, when he actually watches any shot, he would not just watch it as a producer, he would watch it as an audience, as a technician, as a director, and as the audience point of view. So he would always give us tips in different ways, and he always had so much to contribute, not just for us as actors, but for every single person, you know, even Ram Prasad sir. So, you know, surprisingly, every time I see anybody, the first thing I notice is their teeth. And I wish I had the opportunity to actually sit and do things, dental treatments for them when we were on set. But unfortunately, as a dentist, we need our dental chair and we need our dental equipments. Otherwise, there would be a lot of treatments I would do, because a lot of people actually had stains and calculus in their teeth, you know. Balaya sir, I am always going to be in awe of him. I'm always going to admire him. He is literally like a book of knowledge, and he is so wise. He just keeps giving out information and information, and to just sit and hear him speak, you learn so much. And I've never met someone who respects his legacy so much, and who respects and worships his father so much. And he really, really loves N.T. Rama Rao sir. And I could see it, and I was like, sir, I've never seen a son like you. And even Ravi sir would say that to him. And whenever we would be on set, and if we didn't have a scene, he would always sit and show me N.T. Rama Rao sir's movies, black and white movies on his iPad. So he would always tell me, Natasha, there's so much we need to learn from our from his father. And I totally abide by that. He is truly an inspiration. And the one thing that I love about Bala sir is that he really works hard for where he is. Again, he is a superstar. He doesn't need to go out of his way to work out and to, you know, give his best and master his craft. But he still works to mastering his craft every single day, to giving his best. And it inspires me that he's a great person. I'm always and always going to be filled with heaps and heaps of respect for him. And I count my stars that I got to debut my movie with Bala sir. To be very honest, I would love to do characters which are more female oriented, because I somehow feel that in the Telugu industry, it's a very male dominated industry. And you know, I really get inspired by Priyanka Chopra, and I'm in awe of her as well. So I always believe that if an Indian woman is able to go from Bollywood to Hollywood and lead a show without a hero, where she is the hero and heroine, then why can't an Indian girl do that in Indian cinema? So I really hope that I get to do characters like her, where I get more importance and like the movie goes through me more. Jai Simha. I always say this, and I will still say this, Jai Simha is like a roller coaster, and you will be taking this ride with us. We are going to experience some great highs, which will be filled with happiness, filled with love, filled with color. And then you will experience some great lows, which will be some very intense scenes. Our entire cast on board it's an amazing cast. We have Prabhakar sir, we have Ashutosh Rana, Prakash Raj, Nayantara, Haripriya. So our entire cast is amazing. Every single person has worked really hard, and we've got a beautiful story by Ratnam sir, where he's worked very hard to give a character detailing, you know, like every character has a lot of detailing in this movie, and that's what makes the story good. That's what holds the whole script together, and that's why Ravi sir has got an amazing opportunity to display his screenplay skills. And what I would say is that I know everyone loves Bala sir, but I can assure you this, after you watch Jai Simha, your love for him will increase, because that's how emotional his character is, that's how strong his character is. And Jai Simha is a story about a mature love story, about love, about unconditional love. So love is what binds us all together, and I hope that you get to see Jai Simha, and I hope that you watch Jai Simha and you will feel the whole Sankranti feeling about, you know, happiness, joy. You will get that vibe from it. So I definitely would recommend you to go watch it. And we have some great music. You should totally watch it. Thank you so much. Sankranti Subhakamshalu.